In the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the Infinity Stones are six immensely powerful objects tied to different aspects of the universe. Here's how The Collector described them.
Before creation itself, there were six singularities. Then the universe exploded into existence, and the remnants of these systems were forged into concentrated ingots. Infinity Stone.
They comprise of the Power Stone, which allows energy manipulation, Time Stone, time travel and the speeding up or slowing down of time, Space Stone, teleportation, Reality Stone, which alters reality itself, the Mind Stone, psychic and psionic abilities, and the Soul Stone, which harvests souls.
But could something that immensely powerful exist within the actual laws of physics? I think it can. And the keyword to look into is one Collector used, singularity. Now, singularities are mathematically where a function is not well behaved or undefined. An example being where a function describing some quantity blows up to infinity. So calling them infinity stones is actually really quite apt. Well, there are loads of examples of singularities within physics. The one that usually springs to mind is those of gravitational singularities, where the gravitational field and therefore the curvature of space-time itself is actually infinite, with a great example being at the heart of a black hole, according to general relativity.
It was actually some of Stephen Hawking's early work that proposed that the universe itself may have been born from an initial singularity, a point of infinite density containing all the mass and space-time of the universe before quantum fluctuations caused it to rapidly expand in the Big Bang and through inflation. So that part of the Collector's story sort of checks out.
One pesky problem with the Infinity Stones being singularities, though, is that they tend to be surrounded by event horizons.
In the case of a black hole, you often think of this as its surface, or the point from which light can no longer escape, hence why they're black. More generally, though, an event horizon is a boundary beyond which events cannot affect an outside observer. Or in other words, past the event horizon, all possible paths in space-time lead inwards and not outwards.
The event horizon sort of hides that singularity away from us so that we don't see it. One of Stephen Hawking's often collaborators, Roger Penrose, proposed that all singularities, apart from that initial one before the Big Bang, have to be surrounded and hidden away by event horizons. The so-called cosmic censorship hypothesis. Now, not everyone agrees with this, and some in fact think that naked singularities, singularities not hidden away by event horizons, might in fact be possible. If they are, they're likely unstable though, meaning they wouldn't last for very long.
But there are ideas that a sort of collapse of very fast spinning stars or black holes might leave a naked singularity behind. This is something we can actually look for with the gravitational wave observatory LIGO. But so far, the events we've detected show no evidence of naked singularities.
So how could singularities grant the powers of the six Infinity Stones? Well, let's go through them one by one.
First up, the Power Stone. Releasing huge amounts of energy is its deal, which is also exactly what black holes do too. Apart from matter-antimatter reactions, which are rare because the universe barely has any natural antimatter, black holes are the most efficient way of converting mass into energy.
Einstein's famous equation E equals mc squared introduced the idea that mass and energy are equivalent. But that c squared factor tells you that you can get huge amounts of energy out of absolutely tiny changes in mass.
black holes can release up to 42% of massive objects' mass energy as the object spirals and plummets towards the event horizon, colliding with gas and dust, causing it to heat up and radiate away that energy. Onto the time stone. Its property of speeding up or slowing down the passage of time could be explained by gravitational time dilation. The immense gravitational field surrounding Singularity would cause clocks at different points in space to tick at very different rates. So, depending on your point of view, that could look like time running fast or slow. But what about time travel?
Well, we're still not sure whether that's even possible. If allowed, there are a whole load of potential paradoxes which could break causality, which makes theoretical physicists' heads hurt. For that reason, Stephen Hawking proposed the chronology protection conjecture, and he showed that if time travel were allowed, you'd basically need some weird negative energy matter, which we have no idea what on earth that even is. However, there is a caveat. The proof says that there can't be any singularities present, so potentially naked singularities could allow time travel.
For the space stone, you might be thinking, oh, well, that's just a wormhole. And one way to think about a wormhole is connecting a black hole to its theorized opposite, a white hole, linking the two together at their singularities. But when physicists play around with wormholes, they usually don't have any singularities at all. That is, except for one toy wormhole, known as a ringularity. It's a singularity that's ring-shaped, which results from a fast-rotating black hole. And this is what the journey through one would look like. Now to the reality stone.
Well, singularities are points at which the laws of physics, as we know them, break down. So they do indeed mess with reality. Of course, to really understand what's happening in the vicinity of a singularity, we need a quantum theory of gravity, something which has eluded us for the best part of a century.
Only once we have that, and know that it's right, would we be able to know the reality-altering powers of a singularity on quantum scales. Scales which warp our perception of reality anyway with its inherent weirdness. And as to the mind and soul stones,
well, yeah, I have no idea how you can link them to singularities. Quite frankly, we don't understand how consciousness and life emerge from their constituent parts. So until we do, I'm going to leave that one either to you for the comments below or to Stan the man himself. Excelsior. Thanks so much for watching this video all the way till the end. Please do give it a like if you did enjoy it. And if you want to catch the latest stuff from me, subscribe and hit the notifications so you always get the latest stuff. And I'd love to know your thoughts on what I've talked about and what you thought of the latest Avengers film. See you soon.